Chinese police destroyed a government-approved church just days before Christmas.
And that's where we begin our World Watch report. It happened in Yongcheng City. The sanctuary is all that remains of Xinyong Christian Church. China Aid Association reports that government officials and police officers led a mob of nearly 1,000 people in tearing down this building. They destroyed the church offices, training center, and cafeteria. CAA says the officials are conspiring with businessmen who want that land. The church was established with government approval back in 1999. It bought the property in 2003 and completed the building in 2005.
In the Democratic Republic of Congo, Ugandan rebels reportedly burned down a church while people were praying inside. There's no word on how many died in the attack that took place in the eastern town of Tora. A Ugandan army spokesman told the Associated Press that the Lord's Resistance Army is responsible. The LRA, led by this man, Joseph Kony, has fought the Ugandan government for 20 years. It also carries out attacks in neighboring countries. The group is accused of killing more than 600 people and kidnapping more than 160 children in Congo since Christmas.
Three Christians jailed in Eritrea are dead. Compass Direct News reports two of the men died in a special military prison built especially for punishing Christians. The men had been in prison since October. More than 2,900 evangelicals are in jail for their faith in this African nation. The government outlawed most Protestant churches in 2002, forcing thousands of believers underground.
Investigators in São Paulo, Brazil, are looking into the cause of a church roof collapse that left 9 people dead. More than 100 people were injured in the cave-in at the Reborn in Christ Church. People in the neighborhood said they heard a huge crash and then a cloud of dust covered their houses.
It's a bad situation. It looked like a catastrophe. So many wounded people and kids and so many were nervous. There were many people that were hurt and they were everywhere, trying to leave the building by any means.
Thousands worship at the church weekly. It claims more than 2 million members worldwide.
January 25th could change the course of Bolivia's history. That's when voters decide whether to accept a new constitution written by supporters of leftist president Evo Morales.
The proposed Bolivian constitution allows a second term for President Evo Morales when his current mandate ends in 2011. Like his Venezuelan ally Hugo Chavez, Morales wants more time to carry out his socialist revolution. But Bolivian church leaders say the problems go deeper. The proposed constitution would turn the country back to its ancient religions and give legal grounds for restricting the Christian faith. Former Congressman Napoleon Ardalla has analyzed the document.
From the point of view of those who promote this constitution, everything that came with the Spanish conquest, including, obviously, the Christian faith, is something that needs to go. It promotes a process called decolonization, to get rid of everything that is colonial and return to things that are ancestral, not just in the culture, but in religion as well.
The constitutional referendum has brought many of Bolivia's churches together. A recent prayer rally in the city of Santa Cruz included both evangelicals and Catholics, all opposing the new constitution.
Article 4 says that the state will be independent of religion, but in reality it's going to be the religion of the original peoples, a kind of state religion.
Both Catholic and evangelical churches have spent the last weeks informing their congregations of the dangers of the proposed constitution.
Bible studies, messages, and outlines of Bible messages, along with the analysis of the text of the proposed constitution, but in the light of the Word of God.
In spite of the church campaign, it's not likely Bolivia's large indigenous population will abandon Morales, the country's first indigenous president, and their votes will be decisive in the constitutional referendum. Whatever happens after Sunday's vote, one benefit is already clear. The crisis has brought greater unity to Bolivia's churches. Stan Jeter, CBN News.